Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is time. It's Sunday. Sunday, Sunday. Match game. Ice KT. It's... What do we have today? We have Fulham Pro G. The Russian team versus Fortis from Australia. That is going to be so, so great. I can't wait for that. I'm a little bit tired, to be honest, so I excuse myself for eventual miscastings or whatever. I was out last night, so I was a little bit in a hurry to get the stream running and stuff, but I'm here, I'm ready. I think the teams are kind of almost here. Game is scheduled to start in about 60 seconds, 22 players, 23 players. We have Fortis here on the right side. We're going to play Fool's Road ASV1. It's Group B. There's two more matches today afterwards, but we want to fully focus on that. Russia with Full and Pro G did a good job. Did a good job playing. It's their first season, but they're doing actually a really, really good job here. Impressed a little in the first two rounds. And Fortis played really, really solid. As expected, they performed really good in season 1-2. I think they went third, didn't they? So we definitely will have an entertaining match today. I can't wait for it. It is point noon right now here in Spain. So I think the game is going to start right now. We are all set up. I think one player is missing. I think there's a player from Full missing. Who do we have? We have Virus. We have Full Russian Machine. We have Stormtrooper. We have two Virus, actually. That is interesting. We have Cross Forces. Some known name. Bot Mode. I remember Bot Mode. We've got Degris. We've got Make Me Smile. On Fortis side, we've got Floop, Aroused Koala, Kermit, Alpha, Chicken, Ken Yourself, whoop. Stream just started, got him muted. So, we've got Ash Caption, Panda Virus, all the Fortis with their A-Team. This is going to be a really, really interesting match on Fool's Road ASV3. We can quickly, I think we still got some time to quickly jump into the brackets here. We can quickly jump into the brackets. Where are we? We're here. Bracket. Come on. There you go. We're here. Group B right now. It's Full and Pro G. Both of them won both of their games. Pretty even. Both teams with like 1,500 tickets advantage. So we are going to make it out who's going second or who's going third for both of those teams. This is important. Who is going second definitely has an advantage in the end. So we will see. Both of those teams should actually put some effort in this match. Can't wait for it. And we will see. I'm going to listen into the Russian squad league chat in the beginning, and then we'll change the other team. Oh crap. I used the wrong graphic there. I'm sorry. There you go. I already excused myself for that. I have a wrong graphic going on. I just realized. It is not Fortis versus Mamluins. It is Fortis versus Full and Pro G. So for some reason I actually changed it. I do not know why it didn't change. Anyway, doesn't change the match at all. So we will still have that. Let me quickly check. That is why. That was like the Mumblerines thing over. I do not know why that happened. Gotta get rid of that. That happens if you are not in time with your preparation. Okay, there you go. So now it should be alrighty. It's 5 a.m. in North America. It is, I think, evening in Australia. So we will see how this is going to play out today. Australian team on Sunday evening. Russian team at midday. I think it's 1 or 2 p.m. In Russia. So, yeah, let's see. Let's check it out. Shoutouts to all the brave American, North American folks still hanging around, still watching. I'm kind of still drinking my coffee here until we wait to get in. Going to play. I really like Fulham Pro G. They in generally have like a really good gameplay overall. They've got good communications, good intel, all of that working out pretty good. Pings are pretty even. Fortis has a little bit higher pings. We are on the east side. We are working on getting up an LA server right now. I think it's in the making for the next weekend. We should have an west coast located American server, so Australian teams will have better pings in future. So yeah, that's how it is. Fulham Pro G, they played solid. They got some good shooters. Full definitely got some good shooters. And they got good solid tactics, not overcommitting, playing a solid base game in general. Fortis got good tactics, really elaborated tactics sometimes, got some good shooters. I think the king is not here. No, he's not. The king, for example, is one of those good shooters. But they, of course, have a really, really solid team play, really, really solid tactics too. Know what they're doing in general. So this should be an even good match. Fools Road AS is free. Everybody loves Fools Road. Version 3, at least. So we will see how this is going to play out. LAT shooting themselves warm, it seems. So we will start anytime soon. And Fulham Pro G have still hardcore in their team. Just kind of mercenary, I think. He played the other two matches too, but it is allowed. Basically, it's just JJ attack or not. So we are, I think, already last player for Fortis is loading in right now. Abandoned Humvee here. Mm. Do we have here? Is that a rally point? I think there's a rally point in the, yeah, that's definitely a rally point here. And an FOB. Those Humvees, so overpowered. And a nice picture of Coward here. Tucci! Thanks for the sub! I know we're 50 minutes late. Still, thank you a lot. So, we're about to load in. We're about reloaded in, so Fools Road AS we free. I'm going to get ready. I am going to get ready. Let's watch into the map. Mm-hmm. This is going to be a good one. I can feel it. I was excited about this. I like both of those teams. I don't root for a team, but I really like both playstyles of both of those teams. Casted, I think, all of the matches for both of those teams. So we will see how this is going to play out. I can't wait. Jumping into my casting squad here. So we will see big action for Papanov. Everybody loves how Fuzrock plays out. Always the big fight in the beginning for Papanov. Really, really crazy early phase. Always. Really, really crazy start. So yes, I'm going to repeat, I'm hungover, so sorry for that wrong overlay. We are going to get into it. Let's get ready to rumble here at this wonderful Sunday. What is going to happen? We will see. I'm going to fly straight to the north. So the Russian, no, that is Fortis. Why do I not see any Fortis players on the map? That is kind of weird. Now they're loading in slowly, it seems like. They are taking all the vehicles here. Logi moving to the east, BTR-80 moving to the east, infantry truck moving to the south. Having a little bit stuck, 30 mil is moving out just right now. And on the other hand, we can see a big, big convoy going on here for the Russians. 2 FOB Papanov will be basically a big, big fight going on for Papanov. So, Logi is first though, 30 mil BTR a little bit late. MTLB 30 is far in the back here. So let's see how it's going to play out. And the Humvee, I think, might be able to sneak through there without getting caught by the BTR. We can see Alpha Kermit and Mala coming over there with a Logi, and the Humvee is going straight west. This is interesting. Why is he not going for to the north? Maybe he tries to take out a Logi or something, but Faruk over there in that BTR-80 is not seeing Shevik. He's just moving, driving by for some reason. The Logi already arrived there in Papanov. Faruk now spotted Shevik's Humvee there. I have really no idea what he's doing there. Maybe just trying to stall them as long as he can, and it seems like it's working kinda good for now. To be honest, Strikers now arrived here. Double Striker, Circulation and Hardcore versus Diva in that Fortis. And Diva taking out one Striker but getting traded away against a Striker. That is a good trade for Pro G here. Interesting, now they have two Strikers here. That was really, really interesting. That Humvee over there was just a distraction to keep those BTRs back as long as possible. And now Fortis here has to deal with two Strikers. They've got the Fox down though. No hub yet, I think. Nope, no hub built yet. But now there's like sitting two Strikers here, Rohan and Curiciation, taking out another Logi there. So one Logi is down. The other Logi is resupplied. And now Faruk in his 30 mil in his normal BTR fighting against Curiciation. Both Strikers over here doing some damage, being annoying as fuck. Rohan taking shots on Faruk over there, pushing back his BTR. So after taking out that trading away one Striker against that 30 mil, both Strikers here stay strong. They can but Curiciation are taking a third hit. I think he might burn out here. Yes, he's definitely going to die. So we're on 448 tickets for full against 461. Losing that second Striker is not that good here for full and Pro G. So let's see how are the FOBs. Oop, there will be a late hilltop block over here. We can see cross forces and bot mode going to hilltop. There's three Fortis players going up to hilltop. But here at FOB Papanov, all things seems like that full and that for who is it? Yeah, no, it's Fortis. That Fortis is coming out ahead here at FOB Papanov. Bro, now falling back, getting another rocket into his butt though. Interesting start here. Interesting start. Interesting try. Hub is up now.
So FOB is Papanov interesting idea, whereby Full and Progy, unfortunately it did not just work out correctly for them. They're going to save, put and save FOB here in F2 over there. And 30 mil, I think that was... What was that? There should be a 30 mil MTLB somewhere. Ah, it's over here, Nox on the street. Not sure if he blew something up, I think so. So let's check here at Hilltop. So since the Russian team just lost FOB Papanov, they're trying now to lately defend Hilltop or block Hilltop over here. Cross Forces is in the cap versus Black Static, but Black Static got the angle on him. He's still alive. Not sure if Black Static is capping here right now. I do not think so. Cognac, yes, nope. Black Static getting taken out, and Virus, Panda Virus is down there, and Teflon is down there. So basically, Hilltop is for now, at least, is blocked. So for Fortis, having secured FOB Papanov does not help them. There's no bleed for them, and now a whole bunch of their team is sitting on FOB Papanov. Interesting. It's 434 tickets against 457, so ticket-wise, Fortis here is still ahead, and now we can see FOB for the Russian team here on that eastern side, and a lot of move out here to that north. Ketchum, Ash Ketchum is probably going to scout out what is going on. He is able to see Sketch at least. He might be able to see another one. He for sure knows there is something coming from the east. And getting taken out there by a grenade. And Flormer second, Kermit here trying to push to the east, stuck in cover though. Holding as good as he can, things on Hilltop are interesting too. I will quickly fly over there, because I think Hilltop is the most important. Now it is blinking, I think somebody is capping it. You can see a lot of down players over there. Black Static is down, Rin is down. And it is three Russian players versus... No, Cross Forces should be Russian too. So only Panda Rice is still alive, so Hilltop is still getting blocked here. As long as they can block Hilltop, they got some time to play with. And there's only a rally point here, 440s, Ross Koala is spawning in right now, and Kenny South spawn in too, only one rally point, and interesting enough, the Russian team has an FOB close, so they can, in theory, reinforce and attack Hilltop already really, really quickly. They're capping North Village right now. Vehicle-wise, there's one MTLB inside FOB Papanov and one BTR-80 inside around FOB Papanov, so... This is going to be tough to break here for the Russian team. Fortis is having a good defensive setup. That MTLB over here in a really, really good position. This is going to be a tough nut to crack. Diva in his MTLB after losing that BTR-82. Fortis came out ahead here, like 27 tickets. But there's not going to be a bleed. So we gotta see. We gotta see how this is going to play out. Now things stabilize a little bit for Hilltop, though it still seems that the Russian team, they're committing 5 people onto blocking Hilltop, and now Fortis is committing more and more people to take it back. There was 3 in the beginning, now it is 5 already. That even is 6 people here by the Russian team. So they are committing a lot there to that Hilltop block, but they need people to clear out FOB Papanov. If they cannot clear out FOB Papanov before Fortis is taking Hilltop, it's not worth it to block it. Bot mode, they're getting taken out, and now we can see Fortis here pushing in from the north. Panda Virus pushing in a Rouse Koala going for a flank, and Kenny South going for the flank on the other side, but there's Gornjak inside the building already. This is going to be a tough one, and I think they're capping right now. They've got the manpower inside the cap zone, that's for sure, and the Russians are getting picked apart one by one. The northern building just got cleared here. And I think now Fortis is capping. They're respawning and respawning. There's Kenny South and Black Static inside the cap zone, and Core Osman and Critication. So right now it's a 2-on-2. It is pretty even. Kill counts for now are 16 against 20, so that is pretty even in that early phase of the game. Interesting enough, you know, mortars yet, bro. And Rouse Koala here pushing to the south, able to clear that out. So now Fortis is definitely capping here that flag. They have committed at least six people onto Hilltop, and Fulham Pro G is not giving up yet. They're still pushing up there, it seems like. Make me smile over here, and Deagre is trying to go there. Around FOB Papanov, it isn't the flag itself is not contested yet, and Full and Proji are coming here from that eastern side with a really, really big advance now. Hilltop encampment just got capped. So we will see how this is going to play out here. I can see here Hardcore here with his striker, bringing those vehicles back into field. Sitting here on top, there is a 30 mil MTLB still in the cap zone, and he is seeing Nox over there, is seeing that striker, seeing Hardcore, Hardcore is getting stuck on that little rock over here, not the bad position, best positioning. So another 24 tickets lost for the Russian team, 389 against 446. So we will see if they can manage to come back from that. And now they're bleeding FOB, well, not yet quite, but FOB Papanov is getting capped right now, so they will start to bleed at one point. Rohan over here and News versus Shorters and Flormaseca, who are trying to push up that hill. And Shorters here taking out Rohan, taking out News, stalling the attack, getting shot from down the valley then in the end. But Fortis is doing a really, really good job in keeping the Russian advance as far back as possible. And now we can see squad 2 over here, Panda Virus, who just capped Hilltop Encampment, pushing all the way over to North Village. There's a bunch of vehicles here for the Russian forces, well, for the American forces played by the Russians. And for now it seems like that they cannot get close to FOB Papanov. Interesting. .30 mil MTLB just trying to take out a little bit of that infantry over there. That is a really, 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 really good positioning over here by Nox. Really, really good positioning. Like he can basically, I think he even is able to cover the street from here. If not, he just has to move back. They even had walled it up a little bit. Oh, and look at that, ladies and gentlemen. They just put like a half a cent back there to put the tracks on, to just get a little bit more elevation on that MTLB. How interesting is that? That is how elaborate both teams are here. Really, really nice little touch. Just putting half a cent back there, putting the tracks onto it to get a little bit a better angle for that MTLB. And now what was that? Did they just destroy their own vehicle? I'm not sure, but Full and Pro G have a problem because Panda Virus over here already pushed into that cap zone with a squad, and they're definitely capping here right now. There's Zerg and Abdulov MLG and the cap Ross Kurala getting taken out, but Pro G and Fulver really have to put forces into that cap. So we can see Gornjak and Bot Mode 99 pushing here in from the east. Oh, Zerg and Abdulov have been taken out. And now it's getting problematic slowly here for Pro G and Full. It is getting problematic. Bot Mode getting taken out, and it seems like they cannot break that here at Northern Village. They've committed a little bit too much, I think, on Hilltop. Here on the northern side, Full and Pro G, Full is having troubles. We can see Fortis with an active defense pushing out the. $30 million MTLB. Fighting against another striker here. Cursey Nation more in the back now, and we can see Nox over there doing the hits, and yeah, he is hitting him. Cursey Nation trying to reset his position. And the Russian advance here going through at Eastern Valley, but it is not going really, really good. We can see Flormasucker here directly below us on the bottom of the screen, and he is taking out one-on-one, just stalling that. Quaggle's even still on the north side, just stalling that offense as good as they can. Pro G has that FOB south of North Village going for them. So right now there's like one squad pushing in here from the south. They did not spot that Australian rally over here in that southwestern corner. That would have helped out so much, just taking out that rally. But there's a whole squad coming in now from the west side of North Village. That might help them a little bit. They got spotted already. We can see all Fortis players, well, half of them at least, are now covering, pushing to the west side. You can see the rest of the squad going over there. Black Static is pretty low on HP. Kenny South just got taken out. Both of them bleed out. I can't read Kirill still. Matko, I will just call him Matko for now. Bleeded out, and I think Black Static over there bleeded out too. So the cap is now really contested. This is on neutral. There's Medics though in the south. That rally point will be a bad thing for the Russians who just pushed that Northern Village, because the two taken out will spawn there and come again in the Russian back. Grenade launcher going down over here. FOB Papanov, definitely the Russian offense is getting stopped here. It's really, really in trouble. You can see Flormasucker like shifted to the south a little bit. Just trying to hold as long as they can, and they're doing a great job, like having two or three people on top of that hill, and we can see that extended defensive line here works really, really good for Fortis. And they're getting closer and closer to that FOB. And now, yeah, as I said, here Kenny South and Black Setting now respawn on that rally point. Right next to Cross Forces. Both of those rallies are right next to each other. Cross Forces now with a good reaction, taking out Black Static, getting taken out by Kenny now, but he should realize there should be a rally point somewhere close. Matko now respawned, taking out Kenny, and now they should start looking for that rally point. It is right there. But they're just not seeing it. Not taking it out, pushing in. 314 tickets against 438 Fortis now captured North Village. And that FOB over here is getting pressure slowly. You can see Faruk now pushing up with his BTR here through that valley slowly, through that forest. Might backfire. Mortis finally going down. I think it is Russian Mortis. Mortars going down. Yeah, I think that should be Russian Mortars. Yes, we can hear them far in the back there somewhere. Quaggle's taking down, so the Russian team trying to dig out the FOB over here. They know they are spotted, they want to reset that angle. That is, I think, a good choice. They're not making any progress over here, so we can see Wyvers and Stormtrooper working that FOB down, trying to prevent Fortis, who are advancing here from the north.
Oh,
flipped Lodgy over here. Striker still getting cover, so Full and Progy is definitely trying to fall back on that eastern side here at Northern Village. Progy did manage to regain control over the cap zone. There's a rally in the northeast of Village now, but Warlock Swastik, we can see already Fortis trying to advance to the south there. Mortars now going down on that northern side of Northern Village, but I think that's a good call to do. 300 free tickets against 432, so Full and Progy, they definitely gotta do something here. They gotta start taking that Northern Village, commit all those forces they have there in the east on Northern Village. There's no pressure anywhere close to here, 1-2-3, and they've got a defensive FOB up, so Full and Progy definitely ahead here on their infrastructure play. Hardcore over there in that striker helping out at Northern Village. They try to commit as much as they can to Northern Village. But 30 mil BTR has respawned. Moving up. Interesting. Getting quiet a little bit now on the battlefield. And Fortis, Full and Progy already dropping after 20 minutes under 300 tickets. And we can see Hardcore with the striker here sitting on top of Hill 1-2-3 doing some work on Northern Village. I like how Full and Progy, after they lost FOB Papanov, are deciding to move their FOB over here back. Just reset that FOB and now have a more defensive FOB. They've got an offensive one here. I think an FOB in this area actually is doing really good, because it's in between three flags, but the hub positioning is not the best there right now. And they really gotta work on getting their infantry troops down from that hill here in the east and into direction of the cap zone. They're attacking on two fronts right now. Virus X versus Kenny South taking him out. 30 mil here once again against Cursed Nation, and he needs to get out of there. Tree is maybe going to block him and knocks on that 30 mil, but Cursed Nation is still alive, going to manage it to pull out there and get away, get to the closest repair station. Mortars still going down on that Northern Village. Fort is able to dodge them though. And Diva over there ended 30 mil. White Fox's Hardcore is able to push that 30 mil all the way back from Hill 1-2-3 all the way up to northwest of FOB Papanov. And slowly, slowly, Full's infantry is pushing in here from the east. They gotta get into that cap zone. It seems like they have a good choice actually of taking that back. They got one squad in the south, one squad in the east. They might be able to pull it off to cap that flag back. But the longer it takes, the harder they will bleed and the more it will cost them. It's fair on 280 tickets against 480, and it's the first round, so everything's open here. Zerg versus Floor Massacre. Floor Massacre getting taken out. Mortars again coming down in the cap zone. No hits yet on those mortars. Pandava is trying to sneak up, but I think Zerg spotted him. It seems like Teflon Don sneaking up from the north, pushing in now too. It is so important for Full and Progy right now to take back that cap zone here, that Northern Village, because otherwise they're getting stalled. Oh, and White Fox's hardcore is spotting everything. Now he's seeing Farouk over there, he's doing the hits. Like, taking out one of those BTRs would help so much already, would push them down under 300 tickets too. Under 400 tickets, I'm sorry. It's 274 against 413. And we've seen that a lot over here. Team sitting inside that compound here on the east side of a cap zone, but just not able to manage to push over this street. This is a tough street to cross here. There is Kanye South laying around trying to hold, and he's doing a good job as long as he can pin them down on the eastern side. But in the south side, Pro G has managed to hold against the two-man push by Fortis, and now they're reinforcing from the south, so they might be able here to push them out of the cap zone. Cognac is trying to push in as deep as he can. If he can take out that rally, nope, he's not going the right direction. Not a good luck, but he's seeing a medic and he's seeing a Rouse Koala taking out both of them. And if we now can take out the rally point, then they are golden. There's only Rin on the east side. If now full Valrin and Ken yourself, a rally point is still up there, and Teflon Don is spawning. That is so unlucky. And we can see how two people more or less are holding down that full squad. Rocket's getting shot. There is Ketchum, I think, who just always shot us with that LAT, and here Gorniak versus Panda Vice and Teflon Don. Getting taken out. Fortis and Pro G is so close to take get back that flag over here, but so unlucky with that rally points. Eastern side here got completely cleared out now. Everybody is down, the rally is still up though. I have a feeling that like both of those teams are pretty even in their weekly use. Both of those teams are pretty even in the vehicle use, but right now just Fortis is managing to keep the pressure up. Fortis is just managing to be a little bit ahead here. They came out ahead in the beginning. After that move, Full and Pro G tried to pull off that new rally getting taken, putting up there in the east. There's still a rally here in the south, so they basically theoretically can still commit two squads onto pushing in into Northern Village. Interesting enough, I think personally, is that there's no offensive forces for Fortis trying to come for the flank, so Hill 1-3 is pretty safe for now. It's 252 tickets against 404, but that might change quickly as soon as Northern Village is getting flipped again. No rally anymore here for the defensive forces. And here, rally got refreshed in the east, and rally is getting used in the west. Both of those teams one-manning the vehicles. So, more like static vehicle gameplay, but that is, you can do that, I think, on Fool's Road, because on Fool's Road you have more of a static vehicle gameplay. And there's not that many defenders. Warlock, Aroused Koala, Black Static, Flo Massacre, it's 4 or 5 defenders at their maximum, and there's just like so many Russian players. And here on the east side, they try again. Full is lining up once again on that eastern side, but just not being able to push over. Matko getting taken out there in the southern side. And we can see that there's like two defenders, and they're completely able to hold them back. Are they getting shot there here from the south to remote? Doesn't seem like for now. And that is the power of, if you have two men in a good position, to lock down a whole squad which is bunched up too much. Full over here really needs just simply to go in with the numbers and push over. But they have no idea, they have no intel how many defenders are there, and they just feel like it's more. Mortar's coming down once again now. Oh, that is a nice mortar hit. And now after that volley here, they should just start to go for it. I mean, the defenders are still up, but at one point you gotta go for it. because time is against him, and now we have used so much time that Fortis here has another squad deployed. It is one of the squads. It is basically the squad which was sitting on North Village over here, and they're pushing now in from the west. They might find that FOB hiding in the forest, taking that down. And now Full is making a move over here, pushing in, duck and cover, pushed over the street, Stormtrooper is pushing, Noose is pushing in. There's only three defenders in the cap zone right now. So it is definitely possible to overtake that. 30 mil MTLB once again against Hardcore, well, that 30 mil MTLB is in such a good position. And we can see now here, Full is slowly getting in, Stormtrooper trading against Flow Massacre, well. And that is Farouk with his BTR sitting in the back, even locking down that main street. We can see him far, far in the back there. That is that static vehicle play which you just can use on a map like Fool's Road. More mortars coming down now. On that southern side, that southern rally point got taken out here. Nope, the rally point is still there. Now it got taken out by Ross Koala, so that's squad 2 coming in from the west, helping out. Virus X able to clear out the first two defenders. Noose and Duck and Cover were taken out. Noxon is still sitting in the back. And there's more and more defenders coming in. There's a defensive rally point west of the cap zone. And Virus X just spraying away. Alpha and Mala over there is pushing it from the north, and Shortus is pushing in. Noxon is seeing them though. Getting taken out now by Shortus from out of the window. New rally up here for the forces. Interesting enough, there's not that many defenders, so the attackers could just push in directly. And here Matko trying to hold that hill against a really, really big defense. We can see the difference here between Russian team and Fortis. Fortis is getting shot, but they just still keep on pushing. And Matko getting taken out by Teflon Don. They just keep on pushing and pushing, and that is what you gotta do, because otherwise if two men are pinning nine men, you are not getting anywhere. More mortars coming down here between, but it is a stall for Full and Proji. Shot is over here getting taken out. When a deer comes in, the Warlock with his grenade kit is trying to do some damage. More mortars now, heavy, heavy mortars going down inside the cap zone. It is just interesting to see how not a lot of defenders are able to manage to secure as good. And now there's a hub going down here. Ford has managed to set up an FOB west of North Village. It is resupplied. They're setting up a hub here. They want to secure Northern Village. And that is going to help out so much here. That hub. Is that? Nope, that's a repair station. A really good choice too to set. Not going for an ammo crate or anything, and they're setting things south here, digging that hub, and that hub will, that FOB will definitely help out a lot to defend Northern Village. I mean, they're doing a good job defending it right now, but as soon as that hub is up and the team can respawn there, it will be a tough thing to break here for Full and Proji. Here on the southern side, still a little bit of struggling, a little bit of fights, cross forces, for they might, I think, Full and Proji, well, they spotted that FOB already. So, if they're able to take down that FOB, things might change here. It's 202 tickets against 389, so Fortis still, they know they're in a good spot. If you still have around 400 tickets after 33 minutes here on Fool's Road, you know you're in a good spot. And for Proji, things are getting dicey already. It's actually really, really interesting. Ross Koala, Teflon Don, and Thunder Virus carrying to the southwestern side now. Not sure, I've seen the Russians playing better, not sure what is going on today. Kill counts are 170 to 83, so that is not that big of a difference, but here on that eastern side, Defensive force is now finally pushed them completely out. And the Russians are losing ground. The Russian team is losing ground time by time. Bit by bit. There's that FOB and Teflon don't getting taken out by, I have no idea, by conversation over there from that striker. So we're trying to take down that FOB. But we can see Fortis now, whole Fortis offensive line now pushed down from FOB Papanov and is sitting on that hill north village line. Over here, Gorniak is still up. Oh, Mortar is going down. That was a team kill. And now I think the Russians are just trying to mortar down that FOB over there. They know where that FOB is. If I can get some good mortar hits on top of it, they will be definitely able to take it out, but that was not... I need to add 10 or 15 meters to be able to take down that FOB, but we can see Fortis has cleared out everything. Oh, 30 mil D.Va on that 30 mil hill versus Hardcore, taking out Hardcore, they're losing another 24 tickets. That hill over here, we've seen it used sometimes. And now Kisuration is trying to take out D.Va, but he gets away, they're sneaky, sneaky. Interesting. I mean, we gotta say both of those teams are good teams. It is not that one-sided. It seems a little bit one-sided because of a big ticket difference, but that might change so quick. But Fortis here is still advancing. They're not overrolling them, but they're slowly, slowly advancing. It is 87 kills against 123, so it's 30 kills difference. And you can see how slow paced both of those teams are. They're just slowly, slowly pushing the boundaries. And now here we have like basically two FOBs in on one screen. That hub positioning over here is a little bit off. If that hub over here for the Russian team would have been more on that northern side, things would have been different because then northern village could have been defended more easy. Now here, defensive mortars going down, taking out Quaggles, taking out Floor Massacre. Good mortar fires, good mortar shots, and all the offensive forces here are getting taken out. So, Full and Progy, they're definitely holding now their ground on hill 1-2-3, while Fortis still is trying to advance here a little, but simply just not enough. Now we can see a Russian Logi here going for the big flank around, trying to eventually sneak through. There's a lot of vehicles, Bo, around. There's Farouk in his BTR 80 sitting here. There's that 30 mil MTLB, and I think Nox in his 30 MTLB, he's exactly watching out for that. I have no idea. There would be no other reason for Nox to sit here except for trying to check for anything coming from the back. He is just trying to check out if there's vehicles. He's exactly there for that reason, but that FOB might come up. I'm not sure why they're trying to place one FOB here. Maybe what do they have? They have two LATs, so maybe they're trying to take out a BTR. And we can see now Fortis still advancing slowly, but FOB helps out to reinforce here at the front line. Quick for them. And now that FOB is getting contested. Can you South sitting in that hub already, digging on that hub? Nope, he's not digging, he's just sitting there camping it. In the meantime, Fortis is deciding, Roscoe is deciding to not go for a radio, maybe I do not know where radio is. We can hear mortars going down here, more defensive mortars on that street, just trying to make hold their ground as good as they can. We can see that big offensive line here by Fortis going all the way up from that north and east northeast side down here to that FOB. That is a pretty solid offensive line they've got going. And the Russian team definitely is on the defensive. They have that sneaky beaky squad going over here, but Nox still is sitting there. Oh, the lodge is burning. That is. And nope. Yep, now Nox took off his cover. If he would have waited a little bit longer, he would have definitely seen that lodge over here. But he's taking out the squad lead. There's no rally point. Squad lead is dead here. So that FOB got denied by Nox sitting over there. Really, really good play there by Vortis, just putting that 30 mil MTLB there, because you can't use it offensively that much, because it does not take that many hits with his low HP. So they're using it to do the rear defense. Rowan over here sitting in that striker full, and Proji is really, really in a defensive stance, so they need to get stuff going. There was Steve in his second 30 mil, and that Logi got taken out. So now we can see over here that Fortis is on 121, Full and Proji is on 120 tickets against 373. I think Cross Forces over here is trying to defend that FOB. They might want to use it, but they're going to take it down by the looks of it. And the Russian team is sitting. They're sitting back on hill 1-2-3, but that's not the stuff you want to do right now. They need to start pushing. 373 tickets is a big chunk of tickets. 4 Fortis left. Farouk here going to that new setup repair station. That FOB here for Fortis at Northern Village. It's helping them out a lot. Really a lot. Sweet Palms here pushing to the northern side. I personally think that the Russian team thought they're going to get Papanov and planned their game plan on the fact to get Papanov, because after they did not get Papanov in the early stages, it seemed like that they did not really be able to know what they're doing. That's how it felt. And now we can see Floop, Kermit over here, and Rin pushing in from the northern side, but getting taken out. Rin only one still alive, and taking out bot mode even, and that is the entrance here. So if there's Fortis players to back up now, that northern side here is kinda breached. There's still one defender on the north side, but all that northern defenders here are taken out. Rin, knowing where duck and cover, is sitting up there. We have Floor Massacre here trying to push in, but they have definitely breached that here on that northern hill 1-2-3, and well, full Russian machine in a Humvee over there. Is that a Humvee? Yep, that is the Humvee taking out Floor Massacre. Fortis needs a little bit of time to reinforce, but as long as Rin can hold his ground here and secure that northern approach to hill 1-2-3, they should be alrighty. Tickets now against 369. Interesting enough is that on Fullsword, although both of those teams, well, Fortis got 50 kills more, but that is not that many. Interesting enough on Fullsword is that now Proji and Full are kinda able to hold the line. Matko getting taken out by a grenade by Bysleep. They're kinda able to hold the line, but it's still just not enough. And another grenade launcher by Warlock from all over here. That was spot on grenade shooting. Might have been that Matko got taken out by Warlock too, but that was two really solid grenades there spy warlock. Yeah, that northern side over here is getting reinforced now. Virus is pushing in there from the northeast. Only Kermit alive. And Chicken alive. Chicken trying to pick up people. Virus over there is seeing them though, sitting around. Chicken getting taken out. That is the medic down. And Floop getting taken out there by Virus. So that northern approach is secured once again. But Fortis is totally happy with the situation right now. They do not need to push any further. They have northern village secured. They're holding their ground. They don't need to push overly aggressively, and they're just not doing it. Enemy hub got spotted over here. They're trying to hit it, but full and potent mortars are just not on top today. Again, 10 of 15 meters simply missing here. And we can see now Fortis bringing up some bigger guns here on the northern side. Farouk trying to set up a position for himself to help out wherever he can. From here, I think he can cover that whole southern hill. Yes, he can. Tickets against 364. After losing, northern village, the bleed really kicks into. In the beginning, the vehicle gameplay just seemed pretty balanced, but then it slowly shifted into Fortis' favors. Same for the gunfights. They lost a couple of strikers here and there against those sneaky 30 mils. Mortars here going down in the Fortis offensive line, but it's simply not enough. I think the only thing here in this round Pro G and Full can do is trying to take out as many vehicles with them as possible, just to reduce the ticket count. Because 364 tickets right now is way too much to combat Rohan over there trying to push up, trying to scout at Farouk, I think, but there's mortars going down on Farouk, so Sweet Pimes spotted him. So Farouk needs to know that he got spotted there. And we can see that the offensive line is slowly closing in into 1-371 tickets now left. Did another vehicle die? Oh, mortar FOB for Russians is getting pushed now. Ash Ketchum got them all, it seems. Ash Ketchum over here taking out the mortars, and now he's going for that FOB. There is no hub close. And the 30 mil MTB is coming in to help out here Ash Ketchum to take down that FOB. And yeah, D.Va is just coming in with that 30 mil, swooping in. Ash Ketchum is not even starting to dig. And we can see the mortar team trying to rush into their logi in their main base, and there he is sitting right next. That is too close to take down that FOB. He's backing up a little bit. Should see him switching to the gunner. There you go, switching to the gunner, just taking down that FOB. Not hitting it anymore. And now the mortar team for sure knows that there's a 30 mil here. That is a problem. That FOB here goes down. Ash Ketchum taking down the mortar team, but Logi in the south might even get taken out. There's another 20 tickets getting destroyed over here. Ash Ketchum's just spotting to the south. And as soon as he realized there is something coming, D.Va stopped shooting that FOB bridge standoff here. Yep, he goes for the FOB. Takes it down. 38 tickets left for the Russians. Well, it is getting dicey. Now that striker comes in over here. He was still, yep, seeing the striker. And I think the striker will lose that battle. Yes, he does. 14 tickets left. Another striker coming in. Rowan, they're from the north. Double striker from the north. They tried to pull him back a little bit too slow. Both of them. I do not know why they pushed in when from the south. If there was two strikers coming in from the north. So it's 14 against 332. He could just have waited it out in that case. Since D.Va one-manned his vehicle, they could just have sit on the other side of the bridge and waited it out until those two strikers came from the north. Not sure. By the way, a little bit impatient here today, the Russian team. Maybe getting a little bit nervous. It is 10 against 330 tickets. That is a big number to come by in the next round. Bleed will kick in and should end that game in the next minute or so. So let's see how after the team switch, when Full and Proji is playing the Russian side, how that is going out. Ford is here, really, really good gameplay today, really good positioning on the vehicles. Yeah, now we can see Nanon trying to take out that Logi, just taking a couple of tickets with him. I think he doubled, yep, he goes down, that's another 6 tickets. Just a little, I don't know, sabotage there. Farugo taking him out. There's another Logi Humvee here coming in. So we can see Full right now just trying to take out as many vehicles as we can. Nox even can shoot on that northern approach from his position inside that corner. And now, yeah, there's D.Va sitting. And now, is there two LATs? I think it's just one LAT. Farouk is trying to get into position. Maybe they can even take that couple of tickets away there from Farouk. I don't have an angle on him yet. Shavik getting taken out. MTLB is moving out too. 3 tickets left. Farouk is sitting right behind that little hill over there. So this is not going to happen here anymore. Would push them under 300. Oh, maybe. I don't think so. Well, there's no LAT. Nope. No LAT anymore to back it up, so it's 319 tickets against 0 kill counts, 167 for Fortis against 118 for Full and Proji. So Fortis stays strong here in the first round. Warlock with 20 kills is the highest fragger, I think, here. We've seen that spot on grenade launchers by Warlock. He is really doing good, and highest kill count on the Russian team is bot mode with 13. Well, unfortunate match here for Full and Proji. They just lost their push. They got stalled, and they just got stalled. And then we saw it, like, in a lot of occasions. They had the opportunity to take back Northern Village, where they had two squads set up to push in from the east, from the south, but two or three men just stalled those more than 10 people, and that broke them their neck. They had two FOBs defensive setup. They definitely could have done that, but they just didn't manage to. And after that, things would have changed dramatically. So that is how it is for the first match. We're going into a 5-minute break and see you guys afterwards. Hope you're enjoying the cast so far. Let's see how round number 2 is going to play out. It's definitely still an entertaining match, out of my perspective, at least. So, see you guys after the break. Going to show all the follows. Thanks for all the follows. Keep it up. Thanks for the sub, Tucci. If you want to support me, donate or sub so I can do more ISKT cast and don't have to go to work. Would be awesome. Appreciate everything. Thank you, guys.
thank you for all the love. I see you in 5.
So, we are back, loaded in, round number two. Oopa. Round number two, coming up right now. I broke my bot.
I will fix it after the match.
Live on start, going to check the map again.
Seconds. I think I still gotta change the team. Now we're going to actually. I'm going to actually understand the command chat here. So let's see.
Okay, driving again. Lag.
Fort is painting some routes there on the map with little FOB marks.
I'm taking the Lodgy on the south side.
So we are opting into round number two, 10 seconds to start. Let's see if Russian team Full and Pro G can turn things around here a little bit or not. Lots of people say FOB Papanov, Fool's Road is a little bit Russian favored since the way is a little bit shorter to FOB Papanov since US
slows
has to go this little break here and the Russians basically can just simply right straight through the flag. I gotta close my window, 1 second.
Watch the lag, boys, at this bridge, watch.
So, there you go. Roll out so we can see two big columns going out. 30 mil MTLB going straight to the south here and two Lodgies and both BTRs going to the east, infantry truck going to the south, I think is a good choice. To just use that to go to the south. Humvee straight pushing in to the north here for Fortis. We have not seen a single ammo depot rush, so it seems like ammo depot rush is not worth it anymore. In any cases, as far as I know, not a single team has rushed ammo depot. So over here is FOB Papanov, and we will see the first engagements right here. And that Humvee, Alpha in that Humvee, is going right into Q station. It seems like they want to lock down here. Humvee is slipping through. Whoa, and Hardcore is pushing in right with a 30 mil. Alpha knows now what is going on. Hardcore is just trying to sit down there. BTR 30. Oh, that Striker is double manned over there. Sleek and Farouk. But they're getting. They will be taken out over there. It's taking a long time here. One Striker is down, there's a second Striker coming down. Kisseneration is pretty low on HP. Second Striker going straight through into that, into next to Hardcore, into that BTR. Kisseneration getting taken out, and Hardcore is not able to take down that Humvee, getting a lot of rockets where the LATs disembarked there, and Hardcore getting taken out. That is not a good start here for the Russian team, losing those two BTRs, just trading against one Striker.
FOBO is up here for full, and that striker is going to go. Nox is going to strike straight through. So I think good choice were from Fortis to double man those vehicles initially. And the hub is not up yet. Virus is working on that hub. He's digging, but Kermit is pushing in already. If Kermit can deny that hub over here, that is going to be a big, big blow. Kermit sees that the hub is not up. He has to know that there's a digger there. And but Virus is trying to push in. Nope, Virus is digging as quick as he can. Can't take that long anymore, but Kermit is there. Kermit is able to deny it. Hub denied here. The hub is denied, and there's not that many Russian troops here. There's not that many Russian troops here. Hilltop is getting blocked too. One Logi drew straight to Hilltop encampment. FOB on Hilltop is up, but Fortis here able to pull it off. Only the other Virus is still alive in the cap zone. That Humvee did so good, pushing up straight to the north. Logi taking out that hub position over there, by the way, is pretty common. And that FOB position, we've seen that more often now, that FOB, that hub. And
don't dig that
Fortis here taking over FOB Papanov. Tough call here. Wow, and now the only FOB, and there is actually two FOBs. There's a Fortis FOB inside Hilltop. It's not, I think it might be resupplied. No, it's not resupplied. There's a rally bow there, so they can theoretically, if Full and Proji is not going to see that FOB here, that hidden one, they're sneaking through now, they're checking out. The rush got denied, though. But if they are able to set up that, if they are able to set up that hub, nope.
We found that hub over here, that FOB
digging it out. That is 20 tickets lost, so it's 469. After that, it will be 449 for Fortis against 436 for
Proji.
So it will be pretty even here, but still Fortis has the early game advantage here. That hub deny a lot of the team of
Mimsy, you're taking the west side.
Of Full and Proji didn't spawn in. They wanted to do a waterfall spawn here on that hub, but it just got denied by Kermit. Crazy. Swastik and Mala here going for that FOB. Swastik, I think, digging out. Nope. They're not going to dig out the FOB.
Working on it.
Fort is not going to dig out that FOB.
Get rid of the fob on Papanov and put it, reposition it in the middle. I have a full load in this fucking Logi. I'll wait until you
so
hear
Fortis is
I'll drive it to you and then I'll head to North Village. Mimsy, you'll do that.
Fortis is not going to dig out that FOB over here, basically denying any FOBs in 400 meters around. We've seen another team doing it.
I'm off this camera, I'm on the south hill covering.
I think Indies and Paradise did the same, but Salt then was able to push in and set that FOB up. Now Panavar is pushing back that Logi over here. Tickets are 449 versus 436, but Fortis with the better initial positioning here, with a better initial outcome. Now they're destroying the FOB, I think.
Get rid of our fob. I've got North Village. You do Mimsy, dig the fob, Panda, you get the new fob. Dude, my guys are fucking listening. They're not going
to. So we can hear Fortis. We can hear Fortis. I think they're going to relocate the FOB inside the cap zone itself, trying to control. Or are they trying to dig out that FOB? I'm not sure. They're talking about digging out one FOB. Not sure which one they want to dig out. And we can actually see Full and Proji, they do not have a lot of map control right now. Basically none.
No villages out.
They're going to dig out that FOB now. No, they're not. Are they? No, they're not. Something is shooting on it. D.Va is shooting on it, but We're not digging out, and it seems like there is a little move out with that, haven't we? Ash Ketchum here trying to push as far west as he can, just to see any inbound inbound enemies, just to get some. Yep, they want to take down that FOB. Diva is definitely going to take it down. It is down, so tickets now are 433 against 416. And now we can see how this is going to play out. Fortis got good eyes on the map everywhere. Mortis here on Hilltop getting shot on FOB Papanov. Double Mortar here, Make Me Smile and Ivo sitting on Hilltop. I think it's not how Full and Pro G wanted that to go in the beginning.
Alright, I'm gonna hold this line along the sniper mark.
Mortar's going down, taking down. Nope. Nox might get taken down here. I think he might burn down from this mortar fire. Yes, he does. One striker down just from Mortar's. That is painful. 418 against 416, so just with that striker kill, Fortis can buy Full and Proji can buy a little bit of time here. Mortar's pretty strong against vehicles. And this whole squad over here has sneaked through, actually, yes, and Fortis has reset their FOB from the East Forest into FOB Papanov. And Stormtroopers squad here is getting unnoticed so far. Ash did not see them. And they're trying to sneak in. Farouk is still on the hill, still checking south, since I think Ash is supposed to watch to the west. So if they can make it through all the way, there's still a lot of defenders, it still will be tough.
Just holding that east side, just
rally might get denied here though. Not sure. Can hear more mortars going down. Losing those two initial BTRs was so painful. The idea was good for Full and Proji, just trying to lock down the street as soon as possible. But what I don't get at that point is, if you do something like that, if you rely a tactic so much on vehicles in the early game, then I think it is better to put two men into those vehicles. Could have helped a lot, both of them. Just because half of the team didn't spawn in anyway, so you can definitely put two people on that vehicles if you want to deny that, because that was definitely the game plan there for Full and Proji. Now we can see a whole squad here disembarking at Hill 123, trying to come in from the east side. That is what I do not get.
Mimsy core defense. My guys are going to be on the northwest side of Papanov.
Roger.
Why is there no vehicle wreck, bro? Interesting. Another BTR now.
We got an enemy lodge somewhere to the east of Northfield.
Out of the map again, and we can hear. We can hear Fortis. We can hear Fortis.
Where's that striker? I need that striker.
Alpha here. Reporting that infantry truck over here, so they know something is coming from the east side. Look at that Fortis defense, and Fortis playing it safe. They do not want to push right now. They don't want to. We can see that. Look at this defensive line here lined up on the road. That is a solid North Village defense. And there's still this one squad here. Seems like, well, it got spotted. I'm not sure.
Don't send that Lodgy that way. Not send that Lodgy that way. Pull back.
Not sure if that squad over here got spotted or not. Doesn't seem so. And I think they're setting up a double RPG hit. Trying to snipe out one of those Lodgies. Fortis ahead 5 tickets right now.
Play your medics in the core.
So Full and Proji definitely. Definitely has to lose over. Trying to hit that D.Va with that Mortis. And right now they are hitting it. If they now can back it up with those strikers, they still can keep themselves into the game a little bit longer. Ross Koala pushing to the south, though, with that LATs. If those LATs can the shots off, but it seems like they can't. And now they got spotted there by a Ross Koala. And we should see some forces getting moved to the north.
We're gonna have contact out on On the east side, guys.
Alpha still calling out from east side. Contact. Short is moving in here with a Humvee. Mala and Kregel's pushing up. Abdulov is a little bit behind. Virus sketch. Full Russian machine and Virus pushing in from the back here on the western side. There is a. There is Kirisation coming in with that BTR, trying to set up that BTR in the east. I see what they're trying to do here. I see what they're trying to do here.
I'm flanking.
Setting up infantry on that eastern side. Short is getting hit by one RPG. Got hit by one RPG. Second one misses for, and I think he gets out there. So now they know what is going on here on that eastern side. Have exactly positions. He is going out of the BTR war for now. Ash Ketchum here is just trying up, and what is that? There's Faru sneaking up into Hill 1-2-3, into Hilltop. And Short is here just trying to stall, trying to buy as much time. Diva though coming up behind that, in that valley.
Do as much as you can when you die.
I'm getting myself killed.
We got guys coming in from the northwest.
So it is 413 tickets against 406. It is still pretty even here.
Enemy BTR marking.
And there's BTRs coming up in the west. Nox getting taken out full over there, is trying to push in. They got spotted. There's Diva coming up behind them now, starting to fire. Diva is definitely going to be a problem in that striker in the south. Definitely going to do some damage here. But since Fortis has resetted their FOB into FOB Papanov, they're safe for now. There's two BTRs coming up on the western hill. So what Full and Proji is trying to do here is setting up infantry on the east, getting two BTRs here on Overwatch, and they are getting it. Ice Cream OP is still lying around there. There's no infantry around. Up, there's only Stormtrooper, but there's no rally point. It's pretty far back. Stormtrooper getting taken out by Ross Carla, so it's two BTRs on their own. Just trying to, do as much damage as they can down there. It's a good setup, losing their infantry though. Interesting enough, I think the plan from Full and Proji was good, like sending some small infantry front, then sending in the BTRs behind it and have one infantry squad in the east. But we can see Fortis is so up on the intel game, up they know what is going on the map, so they're absolutely able to send in troops and try to work that down.
30 mils cap.
And it was the infantry truck on the east that which gave that east squad away here to Alpha, who spotted it, who heard it and called it out, and now they're getting chased down here on that eastern side. But what we can see, a lot of defenders are now pushing to the west because of that threat of what was two BTRs, and Full and Proji is slowly.
Apparently there's a rally on our Humvee to the northeast.
Is slowly advancing here. Ash Ketchum is watching out for the east side. Rockets getting shot here. And Full has to divide its powers, has to divide its squad here. But we can see a lot of manpower getting pushed to the west, committed to the west, and Full Russian machine and Virus Act, they actually get really close. And that FOB over here is kind of exposed if they come from that side. They never expected them, I think, to come from that east side. As Ketchum now is seeing, oh fuck, they are really close over here. So we should see some reaction. We can see Amsterdam already pushing to the east. And that rally point in the back is getting taken out.
BTR's bugging off.
So they can defend it. Rally is inside that cloud of smoke where I think Stormtrooper is still up. Yes, squad lead is still up, but there's Faru with a striker coming in. Rally is down. And now they realized what is going on here on the eastern side. And can't stall them. There will be a striker from behind, and I think this squad over here, Full Russian squad, is going to get crushed. Both BTRs now pushing away from the west side. They have to hope not to lose a single strike over here, but they're getting away, both at full HP.
Right in the middle of Hilltop.
It is so difficult to break a good FOB for Papanov defense.
Mimpy, can you get a water up?
And now we can see it over here. Yes, that squad here is getting getting destroyed at the walls of FOB Papanov.
Roger, I'll hold the east side.
Enemies east side, enemies on the east side.
Full Russian machine is still up though. Getting taken down, is head's bled out, so that eastern squad is totally destroyed. Nobody alive anymore, only Abdulov, but no rally to back it up. So that got cleared out. The BTR's now reinforcing to the south. Mortars going down on FOB Papanov. The idea behind it, behind that push here of full Improgy was really, really nice. Tickets 389 to 385. It's still pretty, pretty damn even.
Vehicles don't need to sit inside the cab for it.
Hardcore Kirisation now pushing up from the south, but there's simply no infantry to back it up. Losing most BTRs will definitely lose them some tickets. It's around 50 tickets here and most 2 BTRs. So. And Farouk over there. Farouk over there is getting hit heavy by Hardcore and he's losing that, so that is a win. Both of those BTRs sneaked up here to the south and did not get spotted. There's a big hole here on the south and defense line. We can see because there was forces moved to the west, forces moved to the east, so good move for the BTRs to sneak up to the south. But now they gotta get out of there. They cannot afford to lose a single one, so it's 364 tickets against 382. Mortar still going down there on FOB Papanov. Hilltop absolutely uncontested. And now a lot of rockets here getting shot at a Hardcore. He needs to get out of there. If he loses that, getting shot at Kirisiation. Lots of rockets now, lots of reactions here. Nobody hits Hardcore though. But they have to get those BTRs out. If they lose one of them, the trade was not worth it. They cannot afford to trade right now. They gotta to stay in game. They have to take as many vehicles as they can. Hardcore doing a lot of damage, committing really, really long. Floop is pushing in, I think. Floop, yes, he got an LAT, but he shot at least one rocket already. So for himself, he cannot take it out. Alpha over here coming from the east. Squalid Kid smoking. Yeah, he's smoking off that BTR. So Hardcore does not see anything and is forced to get out of there. Not going for the kill, just trying to push it out. And he is definitely going to out. He's so deep inside. There's so many LATs around, so he can get destroyed. Chicken and Farouk sitting over there. But I think Hardcore should be alright. Warlock with his grenade launcher. Just trying to do some damage. Oh! And there's a little bit. Get out of here. Interesting. But Fortis all together, they managed to hold FOB Papanov here. They lost a little bit. Kill counts are 28 for Fortis against 33, so we're 20 minutes in the game, but not that many kills. Both teams now really cautious, really careful. Full and Progy is getting more into the game, it feels like they did in the first round.
That's what I'm doing.
There's Stormtrooper again sneaking up from the same angle as before. I wonder where the full squad is. Which squad is the full squad? Full machine is squad 2, because they should not sit on Hilltop. Yes, we are trying to set up an FOB. It seems like now they want to hammer in here from that northern side. Defenders got... If they would have back it up now, they pushed them pretty in. The defensive line before that push was like down here and up here. And they managed to get all the defenders in. So Fortis someone needs to push out again basically and get that ground again. There's no FOBs yet to set it up. But imagine like having an FOB down here now. They set an FOB up over here, but that is pretty far off still. They managed to push them in, but Fortis is moving out already.
We don't need to be holding all inside the cap.
Really, really interesting here. What is going on out of
get some on the
tactical, strategical.
I'll get these mortars are ineffective if you're not inside the cap. There's no vehicles inside there either.
More mortars going down here on that. On that FOB, Ice Cream OP spotted the infantry coming from the northwest once again. That is so important, even if you play IceKT, if you play PUP, intel information is so good, because now Ice Cream knows there's a squad coming from the northwest. And the defense can set up accordingly. Rohan over here in that 30mm MTLB. Just sitting there. It is spotted, definitely. Oh! Getting one hit. MTB can take two quick hits, and now a double striker here moving up. Nox and D.Va moving up on the south. Where is the Russian BTRs sure. is the question. Both back in main. So Fox and D.Va now, I think Ford is now wants to go into the offensive on Hilltop since they just defended that push. It seems like. So both strikers are setting up here to have Overwatch position. Maybe they just want to go for that MTB in the north, just get rid of that, but it just got pushed to that repair station. The strikers, I think, got spotted, though. And we have, when those two BTRs pushed in from the south, we have heard before this reaction, like, where did those strikers come from?
They're doing what they should be doing, prioritizing asset. We can't lose any more assets.
It's 358 tickets against 307, so Olvo, and we just heard for this quarterly chat saying we cannot lose any more assets, because that is what Full and Progy is doing here right now, just grinding down some assets. And more BTRs moving out, the BTRs moving out from main once again. Over here it seems like that little four-man full storm squad here by Stormtrooper is just trying to hold some ground over here, to hold that high ground, which is an important position. Oh, Rohan there getting hit once again. If he gets another rocket, he will get taken down. Nope. Both a little bit too short. Now he can make it to the repair station once again. BTR is now moving in one on the main, and now there's ice. Four Fortis out so much, and the BTRs, the best chance they had was sticking together. And now they're dividing it up. 30 mil BTRs trying to get up on that hill once again, but the forward element here for full got taken out by Fortis defenders, so maybe not the best position to push up there anymore. And now slowly the initiative is shifting back to Fortis, it seems like. Oh, double striker here against Curiosity Nation. There you go, that is the power of surprise. But he's managed to get into that forest here. There's some infantry here to back it up. Getting away, Nox there sitting there, D.Va sitting there. Question is, can he make it to, can he get out of there? Curiosity Nation pushing back to the west. So now the question is, where's the 30 mil? 30 mil is sitting over here, and Hardcore is scouting something. I think he scouted.
Heavy contacts.
There's D.Va and Nox versus Hardcore, and they both spotted him before. That is losing the 30 mil. That is expensive. 332 versus 356 now. Getting the 30 mil sniped is a problem.
MZ, get a markdown for Koala, get him to zero.
D.Va and Nox going back to repair, I think. And now there's a big fight going on here on the western side. We can see Full and Progy. Oh, MTLB. 30 mil from the hill, but he's not going for the strikers. He is going. Where is that MTLB? Ah, it's still sitting there. I thought he was sitting on Hilltop. He's not going for the strikers. I see the strikers are just falling back. Do they have a repair station up? Not yet. They need to set up a repair station, and they are not going to do it inside Hilltop because inside Papanov, because Papanov basically is under mortar fire. Right.
They're spamming mortars. If we can't return mortar fire, we need to cut their logistics from main. We need to get those strikers on the south or the west. Southwest, sorry.
So D.Va and Nox now falling back.
Repair station.
Working on it.
And now Fortis and can stall here still. Kills are 33 against 40. Full is a little bit ahead on kills, but I think that's a lot of mortar kills and stuff. There was not that many infantry engagements just yet. After 27 minutes, both teams still over 300 tickets. FOB Pavanov bleed is not that high, but having lost that BTR 30 mil versus the strikers, that just punched a hole, a little lead. Mortars again going down here on FOB Papanov. That's why the strikers are not deciding to go into FOB Papanov. And the Russian team slowly is gaining ground. Full Russian machine over here versus Ice Cream OP. Taking him out on the north, or Black Steady and Kenny South able to clean up.
Isn't gonna get mortared inside Papanov.
And it seems like the strikers don't have a repair station in Papanov, so they're pushing back all the way to main base. It's a little bit of ground here.
I'll give you a mark, target mark. Ready?
Just get on the east. Get around the fort.
Curiosity Nation are trying to push back, and we can see that northern flank for Full and Pro-G is a little bit compromised here by Kenny and Black Static. Southern, the midfield is pushing in.
Both strikers are going to main. Don't expect striker help.
Roger. One shooter player, Joe, strangles their main, dude.
30 mil shooting. So Ford is definitely here going for the long game. They're not going to push Black Stacks now that northern flank is secured again. And if Stormtrooper can't push up all the way to the east, they might be able to break through that defensive line over here. There's not that many defenders anymore in the east. Both strikers are back at main base. Mortars are softening them up over here, so it seems like that full Russian machine at least is able to push through. They're gaining ground here, the Russian team. Virus, I'm not sure if he's aware of Quaggles. No, he's not, but I think Quaggles is aware of Virus by hearing those AK shots. So there's no more vehicle support for Fortis. Kenny South getting taken out, if he was not down already. And the Russian team is pushing, they're doing the drive all the way back from that FOB here in C1. Quaggles taking out Virus now, they should be aware of Quaggles' position. The rally is in danger. If Quaggles can take out that rally, Russian team will have a problem. I think they didn't realize that there was Quaggles still here harassing them a little bit. Shevik got taken out by a grenade launcher there. And oh, squad lead down. And now we can see Fortis is they respawned their wave, they're backing it up. And if Full is not able to hold that line over here, they will lose that ground. That is the problem. If you have to advance a long distance, that you will lose that ground. That rally point is really, really offensive, will probably go down, so it does not seem like Full is able to hold that ground. It's a back and forth. And Quaggles took out everybody here in the south. Maybe with some support from that southern hill. And Stormtrooper is getting taken out again, and Fortis will be able to push out again. So it would have been a little bit better for Full and Prodigy to set the rally point a little bit back and just hold the ground in front of the rally point. But they put a really offensive rally point here, couldn't hold it, and getting pushed back all the way back to start again, which is on that FOB over here on that hub.
We've lost 25 tickets in the last 10 minutes.
It's 345 tickets against 310, so that initial lead from killing that BTR is definitely going to grow. And we can see that Fortis is pushing out once again. Over here, the last two Russian survivors are getting pinned down, getting pushed too. So Fortis is just trying to secure their line once again. Warlock here coming in from the south, able to help out securing those two kills. And there you go. Forest push cleared, over pushed for Full and Pro-G. They managed to clear them out once, but the respawn then for the Australian team managed to clear that. That's if you over push, if you attack. That's what we just saw there. Really, I think just from the gameplay here, Full and Pro-G is doing good. They're not playing bad. We gotta clearly say that they're definitely not playing bad, but there's like minor mistakes here and there, and they had the initial problem. But Both of those pushes right now, this push just died out, bleeded out, or starved out, let's say, like this, and the other push just got spotted early on, the where they tried to come from the east and set up on the west with the two BTRs. Definitely interesting to see here. They're playing the chess game, both of them.
I got a lot of run happening.
Right now.
Someone, yeah, yeah, nice. Awesome, awesome. Thanks, memes.
And we can see Full is not respawning just quite yet. And Ford is not going for the attack. They just go for the bleed game. It is a long one. It is a long one. So be ready to get yourself another beer. Or coffee. Or juicy lemonade. And now here comes a respawn wave. I think Ford has just tried to reset, and we can see they reset. Full and Pro G just resetted the tactics, but we can see they're going for the same thing. Whole squad 2 spawning in at that FOB. They do not have another chance since the rally got taken out, and squad 1 spawning off from the rally at the same time. So they're trying to reset once again here, trying to push in. Not very many defenders once again, so they might be able to get a lot of ground. The point is that Fortis has to cover a lot of ground, like covering that southern ground. There's like one in the east, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 at least defenders here. Couple of people in FOB Papanov, so they have to cover a lot of ground. So that is the offensive. If you have a bundled offensive going, which is going for you, basically Floop here trying to go for Rohan in that MTB. That MTB is surely annoying them. And Floop has an LAT, and I think Quaggle's got an LAT too. If they can do the double strike, yes, both of them have LATs. And they're getting close. One rocket goes down, Quaggle's second rocket goes down. That is a secure kill. Rohan should burn out here. Third, yep, that is for sure. Rohan is down. They just went for it and killed it.
Enemies marked.
So, and now they're on 275 tickets against 343, losing that MTLB 30 mil is expensive too.
We're gonna get that LG, although I don't
that's
think
set a little bit too long there, probably.
Yeah, they're not mortaring anymore.
And mortars have been quiet, we can hear that too.
We've got apparently a full squad just north of that MTLB mark.
And it goes once again. The offensive for the Russian is going. Floop is able. Quaggle's got taken out, but Floop is still sitting there. But that forest here is deadly. Shevik getting taken out. Floop able to still hold them down. Warlock got taken out. So, Ford is going for the safe defensive play here on FOB Papanov. Lots of teams do that if they play American side, because Hilltop is just difficult to take because of the natural behavior. If a whole team decides to defend on Hilltop, you will lose a lot of tickets by going in there. So it is for US team, since you have a bleed on your side, it is more easy to secure FOB Papanov and just sit on it instead of going like overstretching and go for FOB Papanov, because you need a lot of people to cover the complete FOB Papanov. You can cover it with a lot, there's a lot of forest, all the advances are pretty hidden, so a squad can always sneak up if you don't have enough defenders here. And we can see a BTR not trying to come in from the east. I'm not sure. They should not have any infantry in that BTR. A little bit, it seems like. So let's see here. Big advantage on the west side. Big fight going on. And what happens now is that the spotter moves out from the east. We can see Electro going, leaving his spot here on that east side. If he's not able to hear that BTR here, and there's infantry inside that BTR. That might, if they're not going to hear that, that might change the things a little bit. If we look at that, that is a nice little touch here. Now they're disembarking. They've got a BTR and they've got a whole infantry squad. Cross forces squad. How many people he has? He has a full squad with him. What are they doing? And Electro just moved out in the wrong moment. He just moved out here. Rally got taken up and now I think they just want to breach in. I think they just want to go straight into. There's only a Roused Koala. There's only two defenders on the FOB. There's only Mimsy and a Roused Koala. They can definitely go in there. If they're not realizing what... I mean, a Roused Koala, his ears should ring on that mortar. And they're just... They definitely are going to do that. They're bringing a Petrolian horse inside. Mimsy is now... Mimsy needs to hear what is going on. A Roused Koala realize what's going on. Mimsy is realizing what's going on. I don't hear anything. And now... Now he realized what's going on. There's a... And now if they can break that now... A Roused Koala is down and now they got a... Mimsy is down. Now Mimsy fall back to that radio. If they can, and we can see all the defensive line going back, this will buy some ground for that western flank to come. And Cross Force is now here. Pushing in, are they capping yet? Yeah, no, they're not capping yet. We have short S. And they see the hub, they know where the hub is. The FOB is getting taken out here. By Curiosation, he's taking out the FOB with that BTR. If we can take out the FOB, there's no respawn anymore. This might change, this game might turn around here. He should go for that FOB. Why is he not going for that FOB? He needs to destroy that. He knows he needs to destroy that FOB, but he's trying to get out of there. The FOB is pretty down. Can you self just hit him with one LAT? I do not know. That was a wrong move over there to not take down that FOB. Now he's going for it. He knows he has to take down that FOB over here. Even losing that BTR is alright if you take down the FOB, but... No, the BTR gets taken out, it will burn out. There is now defenders on the east side, spawn off of a rally point, and they cleared it out. Only Cross Forces is sitting here, and Cross Forces and Matko are sitting here. I'm not sure if they can take it out. There's a 30 mil coming in from the west. Maybe now things start to get in motion. 332 tickets against 221, and now the offenders got taken out, but... We can see now infantry moving in here from the west. They have the ground now because all the defenders pulled back immediately. So they gotta make up for that ground. Two strikers here sitting south of Hilltop. Three strikers here sitting south of Hilltop. Just locking down everything. And hardcore now shooting on that. And now they have to do the pressure. Where's the mortars now, I ask? Oh. Hardcore getting really, really shot there. That was a wrong play here. Definitely a wrong play, unfortunately, by the Russian BDR, by Curiosation, to just not go straight for that FOB. He switched over to shoot for infantry contacts there, which spawned off the hub. But if you kill that FOB, there is no more hub. Farouk over there getting hit and Sleek getting hit by that 30 mil by a hardcore. He's sitting still up there. Some of them worked on that rally here. Little bit of infantry up. And now things getting in motion. Full knows what is going on. They know they have now is the option. They have a 30 mil BTR set up on that hill and they need to push in. If Fortis is able to clear that up too, this is GG. I think... Can you South and Panda Virus here pushing up really, really close to that 30 mil, to hardcore in his 30 mil BTR. Eastern flank is getting cleaned up slowly. Kenya Southo will get an LAT up off. Does he have? I think he has an LAT. Nope, he doesn't. He's a GL. And we can see full getting to the walls from the west side now. They tried so long to get onto that point, and now the question is, what can they do with it? Three points, they're pushing in. Ash catch him, getting taken out. There, lots of downed bodies.
Copy, we got infantry pushing west.
It is getting close. They ran all that way just to get into here. Quaggles versus Sweet Palms, both holding their ground. Sweet Palms pushing, though. Getting taken out there from the north, from Bled Static, out of the Hasco bunker. And now comes Mortis inside the FOB on that hub. More pressure here. Mortis a little bit late, though, but we can see the pressure. Kenny South is the only one holding that northern side here. Lots of dead bodies. It's only Warlock, Quaggles, and Amsterdam alive here. That is three. Quaggles just got taken down by a mortar. And now they know where the hub is, so mortars will rain down on that hub here. Constantly, probably. If they have their mortars good synchronized. Yep, we can see that there's basically constant rain. Do they have a logi? But they are cut off from supplies here. There's a striker sitting west of Hilltop. And he is, so that mortars won't come down the whole day. Warlock, we're getting ice cream. OP got taken out to Warlock. Trying to hold that door from the outside as good as he can. Smoke's going down. Warlock is down, though. Counter mortars, probably defensive mortars going down now. Inside with forest. Kenny South still holding that northern side. Not sure if Aroused Koala is aiming for far or for short distances. It seems like Fortis is able to stabilize a little bit. 200 tickets left for the Russian team. Mortars going down on Hilltop. Just some counter mortars. Striker has fallen back from Hilltop from the west, so logistic truck would be able to get through once again. Fortis is trying to push out here to the west. But it is getting a little bit chaotic. A little bit chaotic over here now. Lots of taken out players, but Fortis can gain his ground again. I think there's more down full and Progy players. That rally over here, Kermit is getting dangerously close to that rally. Electro is pushing up behind them. I think he saw that rally eventually. Maybe he saw people spawning. No, he didn't. He for sure did not saw the rally. But we can see Fortis good even in crisis here. That quick reaction, they're pulling all the forces back from that defensive line.
I'm getting a couple of boys back on the south hill.
South hill now is getting contested by the Russians. Taking the south hill is so important, giving you such a good position. If you want to keep defenders inside FOB Papanov, take control of the southern hill, because you have basically good eyes on everything. 30 mil MTLB is coming up once again. East side got completely cleared out, so Fortis can already only focus on that western attack. And they're pushing out immediately. They know they need the ground. Cross forces over here versus Kenya South. Cross forces was the squad leader pushing in from the east. Now they started to back it up, but I think their momentum is over. Kenya South here searching. There's two rally points up here, so if Kenya can take them both out. Nope, he can't. And there's one rally up still down here in the south from squad two. But they're holding it. Russians are actually at least able to hold their line. To hold their line here this time. Not getting resetted all the way to the hub. But at what cost? At what cost is the question. They lost the BTR there. And here things are a little bit messy. And that's often like Sweet Palms, I think, is a medic trying to pick up. Yep, Virus Exit trying to pick up full Russian machine, his squad lead, so they can reset the rally, because that rally over there will get overrun anytime soon. Stormtrooper versus Quaggles.
Yeah, copy.
And there we can see the difference, like Fortis, if they are in those, grenade taking out Quaggles there, if Fortis are in those kind of situations, then basically they start to flank, they start to actively engage enemies, and Full and Progy here seems to be more passive in those infantry engagements. Mala here over there versus duck and cover. Mala getting taken out. I think he still pinned that grenade. Yep, he did. So Fort is able to Full and Progy able to secure their ground. All the defenders are down now. They gotta start pushing again. 174 tickets against 303. The match definitely is won here by Fortress, but doesn't mean that this round gotta be on Fortress' side. It's just so tough to break that.
Enemy vehicle west. Sounds like a 30 mil or someone. Lucky.
And now we can see a lot of shots going down on that 30 mil on hardcore. He's peeking out and he's getting shot immediately from different angles. He's getting shot from hill 1, 2, 3. He's getting shot basically from all those three strikers. Look at this big striker concave on all of those hills.
Is that south road out of Habanov clear?
That is a really good concave. We've got Nox sitting over there on that hill. We've got there, where's Sleek sitting on that hill? And we've got, where's the third hill? It's somewhere down over there. Look at both striker positionings. All of those three strikers can basically cover that northern hill here. That is what I mean with Fortis is really, really good in tactics and in preparation for sure. Like to know those three striker positions and just if there's vehicles on that western hill, those strikers know exactly where they have to go. They know exactly how they can counter that western hill approach, and all of those three strikers can shoot on that hill, sitting on different positions. So that approach is absolutely denied for the enemy BTRs. That is Fortis strong suit. Mortars now going down. Hub guard. Nope, Hub is still up. Question is for how long? Full Russian machine managed to set up a new rally point over here, trying to push in from the west again. But look at the strikers just pinning down the whole northern approach. We can see the whole northern approach here getting pinned. In the meantime, the southern squad is trying to push in, gaining some ground. There's not that many defenders. They're not sitting on the hill anymore, but since they're all pinned down on the northern side.
Careful, we're light on the east side.
We have strikes there. They should be watching that eastern flank.
Copy.
Mortars here dropping down on Quaggle's head. Panavirus and Black Static almost back on top of that hill again. Like that use of strikers is, I do not know if he hit him. I do not think so. He knows where he's sitting though. Yep, two of our strikers are definitely marked. One of them fell back already though.
They're shooting the mortars again on hilltop.
That was really interesting here to see how the infantry had a problem off Fortis, and then the strikers took over from that distance, from that really, really good positions. And Rohan is sitting on his spot again, locking down that street in the middle.
PTR on the mark.
You're about to have heavy enemy mortars coming in.
Heavy enemy mortars coming in, but there is nobody inside Papanov. The only thing they can take out basically is that Hub. Oh, no, they're going for the strikers. They're taking out Sleek there. They took out Sleek with a good strike hit. I think now they're going for the next striker. Maybe they're going even for Diva in the south, but Sleek got taken out. Well, now they're getting on top of the mortars. Not sure if you need a double attack with two mortars, but that was pretty accurate modifier rare on Sleek's position. Got taken out 271 tickets against 138. And there is some, I think they reset their mortars earlier in the round. I think Farouk here, 440, sneaked up on the hilltop and scouted out those mortars.
It's possible, one of my logic truck drivers said that there was possible mortars getting shot from the 123. Roger.
Western side here once again. All cleared out from Russian forces. It's a back and forth in this forest here, and at the current position in game, at the current moment, Full and Proji can't afford it. Fortis can still do that for 2 hours straight, fighting here back and forth in that forest, but Full and Proji will bleed out. At one point, there's another approach here, cross forces once again, coming with an infantry truck. You gotta be careful not to get too close. He's a squad lead, he can set a rally point, and they're trying to break through since they have opened that opening here against that striker. There's still Diva in the south. I do not know if he's realizing what is going on. They parked the truck. Rally will come up. But time is of the essence.
I'm falling back. I'm trying to hold this east side and the south side.
And we can see both of his teams just going for straight on fights.
Copy. Are you right up that west side out, Panda, if I bring my
enemy back? 30 mil on the west.
Copy.
So Crossforce is trying to sneak up there from the west. Maybe even go for rally. There's Alpha over here scouting that southeastern side. So he might know what's coming on. As soon as you're scouted, the surprise moment is gone. We have seen how strong the surprise moment is. Mortar still going down here on FOB Papanov. The hub is still up. It's got a good position, that hub. It's basically half covered in that building.
I think SWAT's just gotten more.
This is like one of those rounds playing chess. We can see like the approaches are there by Fole and Proji. They are trying out different moves sometimes. They're not going for the straight on. They know they need to break FOB Papanov. But they got spotted, I think, already. I think Alpha spotted them. If not, he's going to spot them pretty soon. Infantry still that fight here in the Western Hill. There's a lot of room now. Fortis pulled back a little bit. And Alpha, yep, definitely spotted them, took out of them already, so there's no more rally. That whole flank over here got denied. The rally is far back
at
the truck here.
On shorty, southwest, they're pushing up.
And we can hear Alpha here calling out that contact.
Copy, rotating.
So even if they just commit some forces down there, it will help out the Fortis, the Full and Proji offense here.
Contact on the south care.
Copy. Logi's coming back. 15 seconds.
So it's 261 against 122 tickets. After almost 1 hour in that game.
My guys will be on the south covering in a second.
It's a game of chess. I like games of chess, but the moves are just not working out. Fortis here is just on top of their game. They know exactly what they're doing. E on the north side, Full and Proji trying once again to push in. North side clear. There's a rally over here. But as long as that FOB and that harp is holding strong. Not a lot is going to change. Hardcore now once again fighting the strikers. There's a double striker set up in the south. If Hardcore is going to lose his BTR, they will drop under 100 tickets, and I think he will. He's sitting here killing one of his strikers, knocks us down, and he pushed Diva back, so he did some work, but he survived there. Luckily, four hardcore, can't lose that BTR another time. So Noxie in the south got taken out.
How the fuck are we on 235 tickets?
So it's 235 against 118 tickets. Hardcore got a RTB and try to reset his striker and repair it over here. Alpha got taken out. Amsterdam with that. Logi is trying to go through Russian forces. Rally is still up next to the truck. Diva could theoretically take it out. I think they spotted the truck though. But no, since he's driving, he's not going to see it. Well, maybe he is. Probably going to take it out. 232 tickets against 114. And we can see once again a lot of downed Russians over here. Trying to push in. Kermit here coming in Abdulov's back. Yep, the BTR, the striker did destroy the Logi, and now he could take out the rally point. Or even lose the striker. And here nothing changed. Fortis once again holding strong. So what is going on here in the south? We can see they penetrated here into Alpha. Cross forces managed to get over it. Oh, Diva got taken out here. That's what I said. He could lose that striker. Curiosiation able to take it out. So it definitely got damaged already. Maybe Zerg shot on it. So it's 204 against 104. It's only 100 ticket difference. That is still, that's not that much. That can be changed really, really quickly. Over here, Gorniak, Matko, and Cross Forces trying to push up against Alpha with Flormasaka and Kenya South. And Gorniak versus Flormasaka, but Alpha is close, taking him out, so it's a 3 versus 2 on that flank here. It is Kenya South versus Cross Forces. Kenya South losing it, so both Russians attacked Bo. And now things start to change up a little bit here. I see something sneaky beaky here by Fortis. After pretty much exactly 1 hour of gameplay, we can see Faruk and Sleek here going sneaky beaky. I think they've got a rally up. They don't have that many people, but that can change quickly.
Yeah, it should be fine now.
Diva is there too. He just drove up. Nope, he just respawned after losing his striker. He just respawned on the rally point. I think that is Fortis vehicle squad right here. Now going into after down on 200 tickets, they're deciding to change it up. And sneaking into FOB Papanov. There's 4 defenders. FOB is somewhere in the basement. Hub is in the basement too, it seems. Yes, I think so. And they're definitely trying to get in there. I think Ivo knows now what is going on.
I want everyone to stop pushing. We just need a hold. We're only on 1 tickets, guys.
Yeah, Roger. I'm just taking their Logi truck.
Yeah, that's good.
Mortars now coming down here on Hilltop once again. But they're not sneaking in. Now Diva is sneaking in. And Ivo's watching in the wrong direction, so Ivo made the entrance. Now they know there's enemies around Hilltop. Make Me Smile over there got taken out too, so it's only 2 defenders against 3 attackers. We'll get back to that. Might force Full and Proji to fall back a little bit. They're trying to push up that main street over here with their vehicles, but Quaggle's getting one shot off on Rohan. After 1 hour, your defense might just, you know, if you're on a mortar base, on sitting on a hilltop for 1 hour, just mortaring, and you're getting relaxed, you're getting into it, and you just do not realize that somebody might sneak up on you. Diva here is making the entrance into that building. He might catch Soldatic off guard. Digris is below him. Nope, nope. Yes, yes, yes. He definitely saw him. And but he shoots preemptively. Getting a little bit nervous there. Losing med chance over here. Sleek and Farouk are outside still. And now there's some respawns. Inside Hilltop, so nothing is going to change there. Eastern side push got cleared out once again completely. Squad 4 got a respawn here in the southern side. And here in the northwest, still a stalemate back and forth for exactly 1 hour. Kill counts are 158 for Fortis against 128. So Russian team now behind in kills. Logi got taken out here though by Farouk and Sleek. I gotta pay with their lives for it. To just delay that Logi push a little bit. They still got that rally where they still can just... They still just can start to harass the mortar base. And I think Fortis decided either they do not have any strikers right now. They have one striker sitting in base. But I think they decided to switch off from strikers a little bit. Farouk taking down Ibo here. Make me smile. Backing Ibo up. And Farouk with the double kill. Mortar's going down even on that Logi. And the MTLB. Both of them have been parked there. MTLB and Logi have been parked right next to that ammo crate. Got scouted by Farouk and Sleek. Yes. That is a big blow here. Taking down those tickets. So it's 189-255. Speeding things up a little bit. Yeah. So here we can see definitely the experience Fortis has taken from playing another season of Pro G and full. Just the more seasoned, the more experienced players. Really, really, really interesting. I think Pro G and full, they did not, like, they're not playing bad here at this point. They're still playing good. They're setting accents. They're trying stuff out. But here it's, I think, just the experience difference. Not that much the difference in skill. And just they did some mistakes, like that vehicle push in the beginning. Got a two-man bat. If you try that. Because if you relay in the early stages, in the first 3 minutes, heavily on your vehicles to deny all the enemy vehicles and put 4 men into those vehicles and do not one man them. That was like here in the beginning, which we saw far in the beginning, where Full and Pro G rushed that crossroads here and tried to hold off all three strikers there with both BTRs. But both BTRs just have been one man, so if you do something like that, then I think personally it is better to two-man them. I know there's a big discussion going on about in general right now what is better, one manning or two-manning. Depends on, I think definitely depends on the situation. Here on Fool's Road, you definitely, Fool's Road is more infantry heavy, so I think you definitely can play vehicles more static. But on maps like Eurythka, what else is there? Well, on all the big city maps, if you play a pub match, there two-manning is definitely more effective. But with all that forest, there's like so many spots, so many hills where you just can sit in your striker and just hide and do some damage and then relocate, and you don't have to be that...
Have we relieved any of the pressure? I'm pretty sure a lot of them are spawning back here.
You don't have to move a lot. What we can see right now, what we just heard, I'm sorry, yeah. I just got carried away by talking.
Just keep
because of that little pressure, see, whole Full and Pro G is spawning on Hilltop now. They're getting scared.
It's just that four-man harassment squad. Farouk actually is sitting on top of that hill that holds team.
Mimsy, check east.
That whole team spawned back, and it's only four persons, and they're just scanning and scanning and searching for it. So pressure got relieved. That is what I was just talking about. Farouk getting taken out finally. 185 to 25 tickets. Kill counts 136 to 182. I hope you enjoyed the match. I know those Fool's Road matches were often like they can be if they're in that situation, like Americans hold Hilltop, hold Papanov and just go for defensive. They can be a little bit chessy and a little bit, you know, tactical and slow paced. Next round is going to be Kohard. We will see a lot of more slow paced stuff there. And Nox over here, last one. And we can see whole squad got pushed back, yeah. That's how it is. And pressure got totally stopped here now just by forcing them to spawn back here on Hilltop. Two tickets left for the Russian team. I think we know it's over. 181 for Fortis. And since there is now a lot of defenders on Hilltop just trying to search for the rally point. But they gotta realize there is not a bot mount. I think, yeah, he got the rally point, but he's camping it instead of taking it out. Somebody is kill greedy. Can't say it otherwise. You should take out the rally point ASAP. Maybe he waits for Squadlead to spawn, but Squadlead still is alive. Taking out Nox, killing, getting two shots though, and now he's not even now. Now he's pushing it. Just taking off that one kill. Mortar's going down on Hilltop now. We are 70 minutes now into that game. 178 tickets against 18. Amsterdam getting hit here by something. He is burned. Ah, it's a Logi. Yeah, we can see once Fortis dropped below 200 tickets, they just stopped using strikers. There's one striker going the wild route here, farm himself. But I don't think he will come into play anymore. Fortis resecuring the initial ground, the ground they wanted to hold in the beginning. And they managed it to keep that defense going. Active defense is how to play that. GG. I'm so free to call it GG right now. There's not a lot of going to happen anymore. Since, yeah, we can see Full and Proji now searching for that FOB, and just out of those four people who came out from that rally point and forced all those defenders back here, look how much ground Fortis gained through that, just through those two or three people pushing in into Hilltop, making one or two kills. Squad one over here for Full and Proji is still holding the line and the FOB, but Ash Ketchum is saying hi to Hardcore, it seems, over there, marking it, saying, hey, there's a BTR sitting right on my body. And we have Rinban. Maybe there will be a more, there will be eventually a mortar strike. Yeah, we can see the eye mark on Hardcore over here. One rocket. That rocket was too quick, though. I think 10 tickets. Hardcore's not even reacting anymore. Second rocket. And we can hear the mortars go out. And with that, if those mortars are going to hit, this game will be a GG. Nine tickets left. And nope, not hitting, unfortunately. Yeah, we can see that Russians know it is over at this point. Interesting, though, to go AFK. It's already at this point.
Amsterdam says you're
There's another. There's Floop coming in with his rocket.
You said you're a bastard. You scared the shit out of him.
And there you go. GG.
Yeah.
Well played by both teams. Better played by Fortis. Just got a. It's that. What is all I can say to that? Really, really good game. I enjoyed a lot to cast it. I really enjoyed. To cast it. Oops, sorry for that. GG, well played.
See you guys.
Can't say anything else about it. Really, really good. So I'm going to stop the stream now and go online. So as soon as we are over, I will go. Thanks for all the follows. Thanks for all the watch. Well, I'm going to into the brackets first, but I will go onto live after that. Well, we can go on. I'm going to onto live later. So we can talk live over the brackets and over that game and over the standings as soon as we are reaching that point here right now. I'm just gonna put this over here. So if you want to, so I can see it. If you want to talk a little bit about it, just wait until the stream is offline and comes online again, and I will be there then. So see you guys in a minute. For me it's 15. Until then, stay tuned. Nice game. If you're not coming back to talk a little, thanks for hanging out, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed ISKT so far. Hope you enjoyed the match. Hope you enjoyed the cast. There is eventually another game coming up tonight at 8. If we can get it casted, maybe I'm going to cast it, maybe Hennig is going to cast it. Anyway. See you now again, which is in 50 minutes for me. This delay is fucking with your mind.